Today I want to make a video showing how to make this kind of a trance bouncy synth pad in Reaper. That sound. You hear this in basically all electronic or EDM music, but there isn't a lot in the way of learning how to do this, at least in Reaper. I'm here to show you how to do it and to get you to understand why it works. The first thing you need to understand is that this is not done by something you do in your synthesizer. I'm sure that some synthesizers have a way to do this, like Massive I'm sure does, but here I made this pad in Native Instruments Razor. Now, that bouncy sound is not being caused by anything in Razor. In fact, the bouncing is actually being done by the kick drum, which is affecting a compressor that you may have saw me flip away from earlier. Now, this can be any kick drum, it doesn't matter which one, it's just that the kick drum is what's important here. You need to have a kick drum to do this. Now, I'm going to demonstrate how this was done, how I built this. The most important tracks here are the purple ones. These are the only ones you really need. This red one here is also important, but I'll get to that later. The only thing you need to have is track one with your bass drum, and track two with your synth. You know, it can be a pad, it can be a lead, anything that you have interest in making bounce, to have that pulsing sound. Those are the only two tracks you will need. First, in the one with the kick drum, go into this thing up here that says I-O, and you're going to want to make a new send. I already have it. So you're going to make the send clearly to where you have your synthesizer pad you want to make bouncy. In my case, I named that track Lead Pad. Do that. Next, what you're going to want to do is an audio 1-2 with an arrow. Normally this would say 1-2 as well. Make this 3-4. And now that's all you're going to need to do on this screen. Next, head into the FX section for your synthesizer. You may have noticed earlier, and as I explained, I had a compressor here. This compressor is what's doing all of the important work. So now, I'm gonna make the compressor to the factory default. As you see, that removed the bounce that this synthesizer had. This is what you need to do to get it back. First, in the direct input, go into main input left plus right, and click on auxiliary input left plus right. That's very important, do not miss that. Next, you're gonna wanna set the threshold low, maybe 35, somewhere around there. And then you're going to want to put the ratio up. And there we go. We have our bounce. And from there, you can edit the ratio and the attack to make it how you want. So you see, it's a bit softer. And that's about how I like it. Is this red thing over here. Why do I have this red track? This is not something you're going to see in any other video. This is just something I do with Reaper specifically. If I want to have the kick drum without the bouncy pad, as you see here, it's bouncy because we have the compressor at work, and we connected the beat track to affect the compressor. But what if I wanted the kick drum without it? Well, it's simple. I put the kick drum on a different track. And then that's there. Now, one last thing is, I want to show you what you should do if you want this pulsing sound without the beat. All that you do is when you want to play back your song, put everything on, like, single everything out except this. You see, the bass drum is still there, it's still taking effect, you just can't hear it. Waste your time with the whole song. I just wanted to just show you, in case you didn't already know, what the, you know, what the bouncing pad would sound like and what it would benefit from doing that. So now you know, and if you're really dying to hear this song, I do have it on SoundCloud. It is not mixed or mastered, so I didn't do anything fancy with this. I just really wanted to make this to show how you would do that bouncy thing with a pad. So now you know, and you know a couple more extra tricks to go with it. So you're welcome. Have a great day.